please take a seat. Make yourself at home. Relax. How are you doing? How's your week been so far? Yeah. Okay, good. Well, today we're going to concentrate on anxiety. Now, anxiety is something that can strike us on a clinical level. It's also something that can strike us on a day-to-day reactionary level. So we might feel anxious about something that we're going to be doing, or we might feel anxious about work or a test or whatever. But also, it can strike us on a much more biological level, where we feel anxious for no apparent reason. Anxiety has become more prevalent as mental health has become more prevalent. And obviously there are things you can do to help you with anxiety, including seeking professional help from a physician or a psychiatrist or a psychologist or whatever. But today, what we're going to do is we're going to look at it from a spiritual level. So in terms of your ethereal body and things that we can do to make it easier for you to cope if you ever feel like it's just getting a bit too much, okay? So the stone that we're going to use today is actually rose quartz again. Now, I know we've used this before, but it's a great healing stone. So what I would encourage is that the one you took home before, if you can charge that up during the night or during the day so that you can then use it, or maybe even carry it around with you in your pocket or whatever, and that'll help to relax you, and it'll help you to deal with anxious situations or situations that make you feel uncomfortable or situations that you are unprepared for, okay? Now what we're going to be doing is, in conjunction with that stone, is we're going to be doing the usual sort of Reiki stuff, okay? Massaging out your chakras, getting in there and helping you out. But also, I'm going to be talking to you about some, I guess you call them, coping strategies that you can use in order to not stop feeling anxious, but to alleviate the symptoms of anxiety, okay? So, to start off with, we're going to do some breathing exercises. So the first one is going to be 4-7-8, okay? So we breathe in for 4, we hold for 7, and we exhale for 8, okay? Now I'm going to do it with you because it can feel a bit weird sometimes, but this breathing exercise is great if you need to sort of pull back a little bit, relax. So if you're just trying to sleep at night, it's good to help you relax, but if there's a situation that requires you to sort of react in a way that you're not prepared for, or that makes you feel a little bit anxious, the 4-7-8 method can help you to sort of diffuse your innate fight or flight response, or the option paralysis that you feel, okay? So do it with me. We're going to breathe in for 4, hold for 7, and breathe out for 8, okay? So breathe out. Breathe in, hold, and out. And again, in, hold, and out. One more time, in, hold, and out. And that's done. Now, sort of physiologically, you can see that that doesn't feel particularly natural because you're trying to breathe out more air than you can actually breathe in within those 4 seconds. Excuse me. But actually, that helps your body to concentrate on breathing and concentrate on taking in the oxygen that it requires. And when you concentrate on your breathing, It helps to sort of like distance your mind from things that are running around in your head or trying to distract you or make you confused. Okay? So it's a great exercise before bed. If you use that breathing exercise in conjunction with a rose quartz crystal, hopefully it'll help you to have a good night's sleep. But hopefully this will help you to have a good night's sleep too. So I'm going to charge up my chi. Good. Straight off the bat, it's not looking too bad at all, which is great. You look great as well, by the way. You're looking good, which is fantastic. Okay, hey, your little one here. I don't know what this fellow's doing, but let's get that out straight away. Okay. So, anxiety. It's something. It's become a bit of a buzzword of late, which unfortunately makes it easy for people to dismiss as a fad. But it ain't. It's real. We all feel it. Some of us feel it more than others. And that's okay. It's okay to feel anxious. Anxiety is a response to a stimulus that makes us uncomfortable. It engages with preternatural urges to deal with that stimulus. And that can be usually fight or flight, as I'm sure you're aware. But what can happen a lot with anxiety is that you don't respond to a stimulus. You freeze, like a deer in a headlight. You get option paralysis. And when that happens, you don't know how to respond. And you end up, let's say if you have to make a decision, A or B, you end up doing C, which is to not make a decision. And that's a decision in itself, you know. Deciding not to decide. And that's fine, but sometimes that can be detrimental to your journey. Sorry, hold on a sec. Sorry. Sometimes that can be detrimental to your general well-being. Okay? Now, I'm no expert. If you really suffer from anxiety, you need to get help from someone who is a qualified professional, who knows what they're doing, okay? But I can give you advice and the experience that I've had with it. And so for me, sometimes not making a decision could be quite damaging. Not necessarily even to me, but actually to the people around me. And that's not fair. And again, it's okay not to make a decision, and you can't help it sometimes. But a little exercise I found that helped me was two exercises, actually. One of them is to basically think about all of the things going on. So imagine everything that is giving you problems. A lot of the time when we're stressed out, you know, like a Catherine wheel. You ever heard of one of those? On the 4th of July or whatever, when we do the fireworks, we'll get a wheel out that spins around and around and around and around and around with fireworks going off all around it. Like, and that can be what, like, life feels like sometimes. You're stuck in this spinning circle, going around and around, and there's nothing you can do to stop it. Well, there is. And the best way to do it is to get into the middle of that circle. So while it's going around, you stay in the middle, and then you can actually observe everything that's going on around you. You can pay attention to things that basically are causing you stress and things that you feel are out of your control, but actually they're not. You can take back control. So you sit in the middle of that circle with everything going on around you, everything going on real quick, and you're like, whoa, this is a lot of stuff. But then you can slow it down and identify the bits that you can manage, the bits that you can deal with. It's like at a party or something. You're expected to talk to all these different people, and, you know, golly, you don't always feel like talking to a bunch of people, you know. We are all very sociable, apart from when we need to talk to people. But the way to deal with that is the same. You sit in the middle of the room, in the middle, and you assess what's going on. Like, okay, this is actually more manageable. And it's the same with anxiety to an extent. And as I said, this isn't advice to live your life by, but it's advice that's worked for me. And it helps me to make decisions and deal with anxious situations a little bit better. And the other thing is, when I was always having difficulty making a decision, for one, I would think, okay, what if I flipped a coin right now? Like just, well, you know, when you flip a coin and you've got a binary decision, you know, one or the other, you kind of know in your gut which one you want it to be. And that's kind of maybe the one you should go for. And also, maybe making a decision based on what you think somebody else wants isn't the best way to make a decision sometimes. Maybe the best way to make a decision is to think about what you want. Does it hurt anyone? No. Will it help me? Yes. Is it what I want? Yes. Well, then you should probably do it. Hold on a second. Say you should just be selfish and do whatever you want. What I mean is that if you think about it, like, let's say maybe your second choice, like, I know that sounds a bit weird, but I've heard people say before sometimes, oh, well, my gut reaction was this, but then I chose to do this. Like, you might think your gut reaction to something is wrong. You might think, oh God, why did I think that? That's not right. But then you assess yourself. You sort of vet yourself. And all of a sudden, that second opinion is the real you. That's the one coming in there saying, no, this is what you want. This is what you want to do, okay? And you follow that. Man, I'm rambling today. I'm sorry. I'm supposed to be making you feel better. And I'm just talking a load of huckum or whatever. I don't know what I'm saying. But maybe, hopefully, you'll get something from it. I don't know. I'm just trying to help. You're looking very, your ethereal body is looking really good. And if you keep that rose quartz, if you keep that going, charge that up in the sun or under your pillow, that'll help you to keep a lovely, clear, ethereal body, okay? Let's start. I'm just gonna do a little bit of rubbing around your face just to help bring up the capillaries a bit and bring up some energy to the surface, okay? So just bear with me, I'm gonna get in a little bit close. Deserve to be happy, you know, and happiness isn't making sacrifices for your happiness. It's not making sacrifices for other people. It's not even making sacrifices for yourself. It's doing what makes everyone happy, and you deserve to be happy. Okay. Okay. There we go. whole point of these exercises, of what we're doing together, is to help you be the best you you can possibly be, and the best you that you deserve to be. Because you know what? Even the second best you is great. Even the you who wakes up late, who can't be bothered to do anything on a day, who would rather stay in bed, they're great. Okay? They're great. But that best you, the one that's in there that you know you think, sometimes think, wow, I can kind of do anything. I can kind of, if I really did it, if I really focused and did it, I could do it. I could write that book. I could buy that car. I could get that job. I could get that degree, whatever, you know, go to that college. You can do it. You got the power. You just gotta believe you got the power. And that's what we're doing here. Helping you to believe that, yep, by golly, you can do it, okay? You definitely can. You're very special. You're a good person. Excuse me. And you deserve good things. And you deserve to give good things to other people. And sometimes that might be your gift. Write that book. Buy that car. Go to college. Those things could help other people. So that's your gift. Helping yourself means that you help others. And who wouldn't want to do that? Honestly, who wouldn't want to help other people by doing what they love? Geez, I don't want to meet the person who doesn't want to help people by doing what they love, you know? You imagine that? The whole world is yours. You're in it. You're sharing it with a bunch of other people. And it's the same for them. We can all do it. Okay? Man, I am rambling again. I am sorry. Wowee. What a rambler. And I don't mean someone who walks. I mean someone who talks. What a rambler. Jeez. He must be getting pretty bored of these sessions by now. This is the 10th one, huh? Not bad going. I hope they've been helping at least a little to make you feel better. And so, help you to make other people feel better too. Okay, you're looking pretty clear. Do those breathing exercises one more time, okay? In for 4, hold for 7, out for 8. You ready? In. Hold. Out. In. That's it. That's your lot. Okay. I'm sorry that was a little bit rambly throughout, but I hope that this session helps you to take back control over your anxiety a little bit more and helps you deal with the day-to-day. menacing and overpowering. It really doesn't have to be. You deserve to be able to face life with a smile on your face and to see smiles on other people's faces too, okay? You deserve it. You're great, okay? In the meantime, you have a good rest of the day, and I'll see you very soon, okay?